So I've talked before about using the Workflow app to create some interesting automations in iOS. It's kind of like Automator for iOS. Apple acquired this app a while ago, so it's an official Apple app and you can do things in it that you can't do with official Apple apps and processes in any other way. So as an example here, I've downloaded the Workflow app. It's free. Just search for it and download it in the App Store. And I'm going to create a workflow that will take a video and create an animated GIF. So I'm going to hit create workflow there. I'm going to make sure it's set to normal. And then I'm going to swipe left to right to go to the actions. I'm going to look first for under photos and video the action to select photos, which you can read about. It says prompts to choose photos and videos from your photo library. That's exactly what we want. So I'm going to drag it to the right and add it to my workflow. So the first thing it's going to do is ask for a photo or video. I'm going to leave select multiple off. I just want it to allow you to select one video. Now next we want to convert that to a GIF. So I'm going to slide back over and I'm going to search for GIF or GIF if you prefer. And you can see I've got one there called Make GIF. So I'm going to look at that, create an animated GIF from the images or video passed into the action. Perfect. That's exactly what I want. I'll drag that and I'll stick it underneath there. So now that it's going to create the GIF, I need to save it somewhere. And I want to, of course, save it to my photos library so I can use it in all sorts of things. So the next part I want to add is the ability to save it to an album. So you can see save to photo album is one. And let's read about that. Adds the photos and videos passed as input to the specified photo album. So that sounds about right. Let's add that. Let's drag it in here. And you can see the default is all photos, which is perfect. It means it's really not going to add it to a photo album. It's just going to add it to your photo library and not specify an album. So this should do everything we need. So let's test it out. I'm going to hit the play button at the top. It's going to ask me to select a video. So I'm going to go to videos, select this one. I can preview it. And I can choose it and compress the video, makes the GIF, and saves it. And I see the result there inside a workflow. But the important thing is I know that it saves it to the photo album apps. So let's go and take a look at photos. So I can see here that it's the last item in my all photos list. And there it is. Now the Photos app doesn't actually play animated GIFs, so you have to kind of trust that it is one. And sure enough, if you export this from the Photos app on your Mac, you can see in the Finder that it's an animated GIF. Or if you just were to share that somewhere, that you would see that it is actually an animated GIF, even though it can't play it back in the Photos app. And animated GIFs sometimes are preferable to videos in certain different places where you post things online. Now, if you wanted to make a segment of your video an animated GIF, then it's pretty easy. You just go in to the Photos app, you edit that video to trim it to the exact portion that you want to make an animated GIF. You use this workflow here and you're set. Now back in Workflow, you can go to the settings there by pressing the gear at the top right, and you can name it. And now you can see that it appears there in Workflows. In addition, you can also go into Settings there, change its icon, add it to the home screen so that you can then run this as a workflow, kind of as an app for easy access.